oh, at some level there's a danger to me revealing the trials that I'm having. We are each called to be leaders, and certainly I'm called to be a leader. And it's easy to think that a leader should always be stiff upper lip. Appropriately absorbing difficulties, trials, personal challenges, so as to provide a clearer guide reference point to those who should follow. And yet, truth is God. Truth is that which rules. And the leadership that I'm called to, that I've always been called to, and for most of my adult life have pursued, is extreme leading edge leadership, which is to say, those who should follow me are those who should follow an extreme leading edge leader, and that's an extremely small segment of the population. I'm revealing these trials because they are the truth. I'm aware that those who should be considering what I have to say and who should be following, by definition, would be those with enough strength to hear what I'm saying and see beyond it. Having said that, I think I know how this journey is going to play out, in the sense that I'm in a depression, a trough, very understandably, having run into granite wall after granite wall after granite wall. My body, psyche, energy, psychology is pretty banged up, pretty disoriented. What authentic life worth living doesn't encounter such things? Maybe I won't pull out. Well, that should be recorded as well. But with all that by way of introduction, I've been more depressed in my life, but probably not very many times. Having said that, it's not a continuing dark depression. I'm able to pull out. I do pull up, pull out. I do rise above. It's probably every 2-4 hour cycles, but the lows are very low, very bleak. I see no hope. I've tried as hard as anyone could try. I've gone to lengths that almost no one else has gone to, would go to. And all data suggests that there is no hope. That this is a graveyard, this is a morgue, this Western world, this United States, this DC, this planet. And that's probably the case. But although I thought I had totally faced that, clearly I hadn't, and recent weeks of experience has shown me that I wasn't seeing that it was hopeless, but I'm experiencing seeing it now. It's taken away my reference points. I'm flying blind. I don't know which direction to fly. I don't know what to try and do. Having said that, I may reach the point where my instrument panel, which I've shown you many times, that the belief in the part of our psychology I refer to as the heart, is our answer. I'm not finding that shaken, but what I'm finding shaken is nothing's going to make any difference. We're dead. This is a graveyard. All of which I've said before in recent months and years, but I wasn't understanding how dead it really is. I'm getting yet another glimpse of that. Anything can happen in such a depression, someone has had such a profound obliterating of their reference points. Don't know where this is going to turn out. It does not occur to me that I'm going to give up. It does not occur to me that I'm going to abandon my reference points. And my guess is that in hours or days, weeks at most, I will be on a new footing. But I can't see right now what that's going to look like, what form that's going to take. And that's depressing, it's hurtful, it's frightening, it's worrisome. It leaves me in a trough that is an unpleasant place to be. An article headline recently, within the last couple of days, which I posted, as I recall, spoke of empathy fatigue or compassion fatigue. That may be an apt description for part of what's going on with me. Some of my divorce from the intimate unity that I had with the tens of billions that our apathy, our inaction, are condemning to torture on planet Earth forever. My solidarity, unity of feeling, empathic connection was huge. For many, 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 many weeks, that's substantially disconnected right now. That may be my entire problem. But finding the energy to reconnect, finding the wisdom, the courage, the time to reconnect, to regenerate that part of my imagination is so far escaping me. To some degree, that's due to my call to render my video logs into textual book form, which I'm doing. That takes my mind elsewhere to a significant degree. I'm sensing whether I need to suspend the writing of the book to regenerate those connections. So far, my guess is not. I'm to muddle through this get the book done and then redirect my energies. But I'm looking at that. Well, I'm going to stay tuned to this. You would be wise to as well. It does occur to me that everyone that has plowed a new path for us, that has beaten a new path for us throughout history, has probably had times at least as dark as mine, going way out in front of where people are, where people have been, an immense loneliness. Absence of almost any and all information necessary to get one's bearings, to have confidence, or the confidence one would like in where one is going. I in no way do I suspect that my experience is a new human experience. It probably is the experience of almost all. Just this instant, it popped into my mind something that I've known for years but not thought of about Teresa of Calcutta, who I highly regard. And that is, late in life, she confided in someone late in her life, that it had been decades since she had had what she experienced as a spiritually intimate contact with Jesus, her light, as she had earlier in her life, that earlier contact was responsible for her life's direction. That it had been decades since she had had such a contact. That certainly relates to what I'm experiencing.